colors coming from our left, and they will be at midcourt as we await them to get into place, and we have our anthem here today. Messages from your local stations. Roger Bacon and Central Catholic starting lineups are on the way. You're listening to the OHSAA Radio Network.
OHSAA Commissioner Dr. Dan Ross on safe driving. Parents and coaches, please set the rule. We want to go home and yourself. We want to see all of you at the moment.
A message from the Ohio High School Athletic Association.
Check out the new era of Columbus Pro Soccer when the Black and Gold kicks off its 2014 home schedule at opening match on Saturday, March 22nd at 6 p.m. versus conference rival Philadelphia Union. The first 10,000 fans will receive a crew magnet schedule presented by Papa John's Pizza. Your Major League Soccer experience starts at only $23. Visit thecrew.com or call 614-447-CREW to get your opening match tickets today.
Former Ohio State and NFL quarterback Bobby Moy on Life Lessons in Sport.
Columbus Schools and the Ohio High School Athletic Association share in the mission of educational athletics. That means that school sports are an extension of the classroom and play an important part in a well-rounded education. Student athletes do a lot more than just play sports, but it's the lessons they learn in school sports.
This message brought to you by the Ohio High School Athletic Association.
Hey, this is Richard Peters. With the Marathon Visa credit card, you can start saving like a king. Save up to 25 cents a gallon. It's a good deal. So what are you waiting for? Stop in the local marathon and buy a marathon. Fueling the American spirit.
Subject to credit approval, the Marathon Visa Credit Card Rebate Program is provided by Marathon Petroleum Company LP, which is solely responsible for the program's operation. Marathon may change the terms of the program at any time.
The OHSAA Radio Network would like to welcome those listening around the state and around the world. Great affiliates that include Marietta's WJW 630 AM, Willoughby WELW 1330 AM, Wheeling's WBWKKX 1600 AM, Toledo's WLQR 106.5 FM, Paulding's WBAU 1640 AM, Ontario's WRGM 97.3 FM at 1440 AM, and Mountainville's WSLY 1370 AM. And our online affiliates, JJHelps.com, RadioNorthCoast.com, and WCOQRadio.com, and go along with ZSportsLive.com. Those are some of our local affiliates, and we'll allow them an opportunity to identify themselves. Pause. You're listening to the OHSAA Radio Network. Online Final, and they are brought to you by Farmers Insurance. See how your knowledge of the local Farmers agent can save you money. 1-800-FARMERS or visit farmers.com. We are insurance. We are Farmers. For Lima Central Catholic at 23-4, they will start like this. Xavier Simpson, the number 9 in sophomore, averaging 17.8 points per game. Artize Kimbrough, a 6-1 senior, averaging 18.6, co-player of the year in Division 3. Trey Cobb, a 6-1 sophomore, he is averaging 9.3 points a contest. Dantes Walton, a 6-4 sophomore, averaging 9.7 points a game. And Jake Williams, a 6'2" junior, he is averaging 5.2 contest. For the Spartans of Roger Bacon at 22-4, they'll start Reggie Williams at 5'10" of the senior, averaging 4.3 points a game. Cody Nisa, a 6-1 senior, he is averaging 6.4. Samir Emerson, a 6'3" junior, he is averaging 8 points per game. Fred Moore, 6'7" senior, at 10.6 and 6.8 rebounds. And co-player of the year, Carlos Jackson, 6'4" senior, averaging 16.3 points and 3.5 rebounds per game. The coaches are Frank Kill for Central Catholic in his fourth season, Brent Mahaney, 7-14, and Roger Bacon, Brian Neal, in his ninth season, with a record of 146-76. Team playing for a state championship game. Let's get to your keys, and we'll first start with Lima Central Catholic today.
Well, when I think of the Spartans, I think of their 94 leads of pressure for 32 minutes. But I think one of the keys to this basketball team is the interior defense. This is not going to be an up and down game all the time, so they're going to have to make sure they can defend on the inside. I think the Thunderbirds can do that, limit their turnovers and mistakes. I think they'll have a chance to win their ninth basketball game in a row.
And for one, the state camp team, which comes in here with 2,000 points, scores, and finally getting here with some box on their knees today.
Well, I think defensively, they're going to have to retain both Reggie Williams and a couple other players, Simpson and Kimbrough in the backcourt, and make sure they defend well from there. In order to get your pressure up, you have to score baskets either from the free throw line or from the perimeter.
Starting lineup just about finished with the introduction of players. We'll tell you the trio of officials for today's semifinal game are Kenneth McLean out of Cleveland, Christopher Barringer of Westlake, and Ken Farley Jr. of Lakewood. Lima Central Catholic, visiting team in gray uniforms today, with the white numerals trimmed in red, the lettering trimmed in red as well, with some light gray, red, Columbia blue, another variation of colors there on the side of the uniform for Lima Central Catholic, with that T-Bird logo on the bottom of the shirt. They go with some powder blue shoes as well. Matches my partner's shirt. For Roger Bacon, very simple, old whites with brown trim, brown lettering, and numerals trimmed in yellow. Reggie Williams wants the basketball. The official's not going to give it to him. He's not going to be able to play with it beforehand. These are the Viking uniforms you wore in Waterston, my friend, years back.
We were pretty simple in our design and color scheme at Bishop Waterston. This is a different era than we're actually living in now, partner, so things are a little bit different.
Got some paisley, we've got some cross. This looks like I picked out this outfit in the morning without the lights on. All right, we're ready to go. Ball's in the air, and Roger Bacon will win the opening tip. They're going left to right, and immediately they get right into it with Emerson coming out on top, man-to-man here by Central Catholic to start defensively. Carlos Jackson's first touch of the day. Comes over here to the right side for Neeson. Now back out on top, Reggie Neeson. Reggie Williams, I should say. Now the drive by Jackson is no good, and rebounded by Jake Williams for Central Catholic. They will look to push it quickly down the floor as Kimbrough, his first shot of the day, is up and in.
Well, there's one of our key players for the Thunderbirds. Just right off of this shot, right to the basket, easy score.
2-0 for Central Catholic. And the ball in and out of the hands of Emerson and a turnover. Now the pass down the court, tipped out of bounds at center court. It'll still be Central Catholic basketball.
You can feel the pace of the game and the volume of energy that both of these teams want to play with. It's going to be up and down. It'll be interesting to see who can really execute when you have to break it down into a half-court offense.
Zips it, picked up by Reggie Williams at midcourt, man-to-man by the Spartans. We'll be circus shot will bounce around and go in for Trey Cobb's foot up and zip it down. And here's the pressure we talked about. This game unfolds a little bit. We see that pressure just kind of volume up as the game goes. Williams will go out to the high post. Fred Moore hands it off to Jackson. He just fires out a three on the left side. T-Bird breaks it up and pushes it to Simpson. Into the left wing with the basketball. Keeps it dribble, bounces it off his foot, gets it back, hands it over, and swishing home a three is Martise Kimbrough. And it's 7-1.
3 points for Anthony Martise Kimbrough.
Martise Kimbrough has good range. Those are the shots that his coach is going to give him confidence in shooting.
And it's 40 in. Williams. Cody Neeson is 39
points
this season and tries to take it on the board. Court Manningham pressing behind his partner and walking across the timeline is Trey Cobb. Stop the front court, now laying it off to Kimbrough. 7-3 and DeBarrow is set to catch it. From the left of the basketball is Kimbrough over the lane, quickly double team. Now on top is walking around the right side, driving down the right side of the lane and laying it in is Xavier Simpson.
Off to a great
start offensively. Most of the shots are getting close to the basket. Of course, the three from the perimeter as well. Got themselves off to a good start with a 9-3 lead.
5:24 to play here in the opening quarter. Williams on the left wing in front of the Central Catholic bench, and it's swatted away. Gathers it back. Now it's Epperson with a three in the left-hand corner. That's no good. Rebound into the corner. Out of bounds. Last touch by Rocky Bacon. It'll be Central Catholic ball in our first start. Talking about giving our pregame senior average. 1,000 point scorers on this Spartan club. That didn't take long. Coach Neal will go right to Rensos. Last 6 threes and a 6'6" senior. Got to be able to make something happen here early in this first quarter.
Simpson out on top, splits a double team around the screen, bounces it down low. 1-2 head fakes and putting it up and rolling it in is Jake Williams. And a quick timeout of the game by Brian Neal. 30-second timeout.
Timeout, Roger Bacon, 37 timeout.
And it's 11.
There's another more exciting than anything that last time shot, but I
need to be a lot of proud and efficient food service provider of the OHSAA and support high school student athletes across the state of Ohio. Visit marathon.com to play more than Chris. Marathon has over 5,000 locations to serve you. Marathon, playable by American Sports.
And I think a great way to approach playing in this building. You're a good offensive team. Just try to get something quick in transition. But more importantly, you don't know what your outside shooting's going to be. So what I really like about Central Catholic is they've had the ability to get the ball close to the basket, easy shots. They're 5-5 from the field. Four of those have come almost easy, uncontested layup. That's how you get your basketball team off the court.
That's 11-3, an 8-point advantage here in the first quarter of play. See if Roger Bacon can get their feet under them here. They're off to a 1-4 start with a turnover here in the opening moments. Now on top of the Reggie Williams. Gets to the stop at the top of the team. Keeps that dribble alive. Back up with Anissa to the foul line. Now puts it back out on top. Jackson looks down low and he threw it away. Intercepted and here comes Kimbrough down the floor. Dumps it off to Cobbs who gets fouled into that free throw.
Take a look under first. Not great size, height wise. They got three perimeter players. Simpson, Kimbrough, and Cobbs that can really push the ball. As you can tell, they play a lot of basketball together. They know the timing and they're synced in really good right now at the start of this basketball game.
Cobbs, a 68% free throw shooter. Front rim is the first one. Ethan O'Connor, a 6'2 sophomore, will replace Jake Williams in the Central Academy lineup, their first sub. O'Connor averaging just over a point per game. Second free throw coming up by Cobbs. Also no good. Battle for the rebound will be gathered by Wood. Hands it off inside to O'Connor, and an offensive foul will be called against Ethan O'Connor.
Good job by Carlos Jackson, stepping in, making the contact, and the charge. Easy call for the official.
So it'll be Roger Bacon basketball. The Spartans averaging almost 74 points per contest off of a slow start with only three. If they approach it midway point in the corner, he gets three down low on a nice look.
by Treadwell.
Carlos Jackson, his first two. Quickly back the other direction. A little floater by Simpson is no good. Ball tipped out. O'Connell will put it up on the right hand, though. Rebound, Roger Bacon and Fred Moore. Really throwing those elbows around, trying to get out of traffic. Now William Kukla, double teamed, and we're going to foul here on Simpson down. You can see the pace of the game has increased after we've gone through this first quarter. Thunderbirds get the second and third opportunities in their offensive end. Down at this end, Roger Bacon is still trying to find the rhythm offensively. Previous possession with back screen. They kind of set up for a lob situation. They end up getting layup, no pass.
Trey McBride has come in for Roger Bacon, a sophomore at 6'1". He averages over 7 points for the ball game. So big guy coming on deep half. The Spartans, 3:38 to play here first quarter. And Lima Central Catholic leading 11-5. On top, this is McBride with basketball. He'll hand it off to Jackson. Jackson now will come across with the pass to Reggie Williams. Back out on top of the red one. Back to the left side of McBride. Down the left side of the lane. Fretzos had his shot blocked by Wolf. Quickly back the other direction. It's Craig Cobbs out of control. Then had his shot blocked inside. Shot up no by Wolf. But he got fouled right across the arm on the way up. Two free throws for Nantes Wolf coming up after the foul on Williams.
Ball at every opportunity, off a miss, off a make, on turnovers, off a steal, pushing it hard.
At the line, it'll be Walton shooting two. He's a 67% free throw shooter. The first one bounces off the open three right now at the line.
Sometimes they don't seem to matter early in the basketball game, but once we get into that fourth quarter and the game's on the line, making these things
Walton gets the second. The Tigers lead back out to seven. And it'll be Roger Bacon basketball. Corey Stewart, 6'4 senior, has come in for the first time for Lima Central Catholic. And it's Reggie Williams out on top of the basketball. Out on the left side of the McBride, out of the other 3-point line. Back out to Williams, top of the key. Williams now will hand it off to Jackson. Picked up right there by Kim. Now back to Williams, ducks up to the defender, back to the baseline, dumps it over to Trey McBride, and had a shot blocked behind, but it follows.
Good action offensive. Corey Stewart got it off for the foul, 14-3. Again, I think what you're seeing for Roger Bacon offensively is a little motion offense, a lot of back screens, a lot of down screens. Spacing is a critical element for Brian Deal's basketball team. When the spacing is good, and they deliver the extra pass, they're very, very good at the offensive end.
First free throw by McBride is good. William Green, a 5'10 sophomore, has now entered for Roger Bacon. And back into the lineup for Aaron Peterson. And to the line, McBride for the second free throw. Only a 52% free throw shooter, but he gets them both here. And Lima Central Catholic now leads 12-6 with 2:50 to play in the first quarter. Pass deflected and stolen by Roger Bacon in the backcourt to Peterson. He'll take it down the floor with the left hand. To the free throw line, right to the rack, put it in and got fouled. Damir Epperson with a chance of a three-point play.
Epperson bringing the ball all the way across the timeline. Nice little inside-out dribble, left hand to the basket. Nice first assist for the team.
Foul went against Epperson. And Epperson with a chance of a three-point play. After the quick start by Central Catholic, Roger Bacon has more than gotten their feet under him. Got right back in this now. Defense has created a couple of stops and turnovers. And now Epperson with his chance of a three-point play. Left-hander gets it to crawl in. It's down to a two-point game at 12-10. And here comes the press by Roger Bacon. The traffic action in the basket. Simpson will get it across the timeline here for the Thunderbird. Pass down to the left-hand corner, nearly stolen as the pass goes across court now. And back out on top, O'Connor hits Simpson. And Roger Bacon extends the pressure in the half-court defense. Now long cross court pass is going to be tipped. It's maintained, though, by O'Connor. Now the right-hand corner is Stewart. And it's very helter-skelter right now for the team. Driving and getting a reverse layup, though, is Craig Cobbs. Wow.
A good finish at the basket. And they fail offensively. They had to speed up because the defensive pressure of Roger
fake, double teams, traps, trying to run through passes.
Renzo's along the baseline here for Roger Bacon. Got out of control, looked like he tried to throw to a teammate that didn't exist. Renzo shakes his head as he walks back in for a turnover. They set the camera leading by 1:49 to play here in the fourth.
Anytime they can get a dead ball situation, you'll see the pressure. This time it's a man-to-man. Last time it was a 2-2-1. Got a three-quarter court pressure. So you'll see different levels of pressure from Roger Bacon.
On a drive, Simpson's going to get fouled out near the free throw lane. And it's going to be whistled against William Green, his first. Foul starts to mount up a little bit on both sides. Four against Seven Catholic, three against Roger Bacon. A lot of the early stages of the game that he's played is 76 and a half minutes. And Simpson driving down the right side, backs it up into the lane, hands it off down to Kimball.
Back in the half court
Comfy right now. I understand why now. Fresno steps off the bench and gets his numbers.
He's flying all over the court, taking shots, going after his misses. That's what you want, though, in a state semifinal game.
Xavier Simpson and those two fouls will now check out for Central Catholic, replaced by Aiden O'Connor. He is a 6'1 junior for Central Catholic. Also now out there is Ethan O'Connor as the ball is jarred free, but back into the hands of Prince. It's out on top. Boy, Central Catholic extending that man-to-man defense right now. Williams drives down the lane, just pinballing off the body. Got his own miss, double team, triple team down low. Throws it off a T-Bird out of bounds. It'll stay with Roger Bacon. We've played 3 minutes of our second quarter, and it's getting amped up.
Williams passed first guy. That time, he got himself slithered between two defenders to the basket.
Inbounds out on top. Prince Oates will lob the board down low. Double team, one dribble. Got him. No. 3 second violation going to be called against Fred Moore. So, all's going back over to Central Catholic and Ben Holtz, a 6'6 junior. Check into the lineup now for Roger Bacon. Dave will pick up the court press.
They might be in that ball situation. Face guard, hand on the ball, zigzag down the court. Tough to zigzag. These Thunderbirds, though.
And right to the glass, laying it in. Ethan O'Connor after contact was made on the pass by Trey Cox. 22-17, Central Catholic, 4:38 to play in the half. Renzo, south between the circles to Williams. Down left side, Carlos Dex. Across over to the bucket. Will draw off the glass. Rebound grabbed by Walker. And a foul on Roger Bacon. Number 5 against the Spartans.
Trying to protect the basketball when he comes down to rebound. 3 or 4 gray jerseys all over that defender. Good job protecting the ball.
Williams back into the game now for Central Catholic, and Holtz will sit down. Foul against Prentzos for Roger Bacon. 4:26 to play, and a whistle on the inbounds, and a hold by Williams. Who remember moments ago was asking for some sort of push-off foul on the other end, and so Reggie Williams picks up his second. Dave essentially now for both point guards. Xavier Simpson on one side, Reggie Williams on the other. He's got 2 fouls.
You can see both these teams are using 94 feet of basketball, the entire court. A lot of pressure on the ball. You really got to manage the basketball well if you have the ball in your hands.
And back out there is Xavier Simpson. He's got it, floats down the lane, and floats one in, and there was contact. And it could have been the first foul, but nothing called. And Simpson now with 6.
The runner, the floater. Guards have to have that type in their arsenal to make sure they get the ball high off the defender.
7-point Central Catholic lead, and here's a pass deflected by Simpson. Races down the floor and out of control, throws it well ahead. And no deflection, so a turnover. Trying to make a basketball. Turnover against Central Catholic. That is 5 now against Central Catholic. Since Roger Bacon in his first half.
Nice move to have, but you got to pick and choose when you're going to use it.
3:27. both coaching hard right now. It's the inbounds and right back underneath. Kimbrough put it in with a pass by Dante.
2 points for 21. Kimbrough.
Out of bounds underneath their own basket. In the last six possessions, they scored easy baskets off. Something to watch for as this game unfolds.
Largest first half lead, 9. A collision away from the ball is a foul that's going to go against Central Catholic. And free throws are coming up for Roger Bacon. As Dantes Walton just collected his second foul. The free throws are coming up. And it's going to be Fred Morris the line here to shoot a 1-1.
I see the officials have kind of tightened it up just a little bit. They'll probably see a little action both ends of the floor, just making sure they got full control.
One thing to have an up-tempo game is tough to keep up with sometimes. A lot of physicality to an up-tempo game. Tricky to officiate. Like a job
is. Well, I think the quickness and the athleticism of what these kids has something to do with that. They can cover a lot of space in a short amount of time.
Both free throws good by Moore. Leads down to 7 and goes inside underneath the Corey Stewart as the first layup no good. Rebound volleyball out. Grabbed by Trey Cobbs into the lane. Shot no good. Prentzos tips the rebound. To the floor went Williams, but I feel he got hit with a foul. Well, I guess not. It's on Prentzos on the rebound. That'll be his second for Roger Bacon. And bonus time now for Central Catholic. Jake Williams will go to the line. Central Catholic a couple of subs as Simpson checks out again along with Ethan Pye. This is a 1-1 by Jake Williams that's coming. 65% free throw shooter. And the means flips it forward and it's good.
On another play is Jake Williams. Times he's been on the floor. Very active, full of energy. Staying on the glass. One of the key players. Only scoring about 5 points a game. His rebounding and his ability to keep 3 possessions alive for the Thunderbirds. A key element for that team.
Under 3 to play, got them both, and it's 28-19, back out to a 9-point advantage. Everson, left side, Neeson, inside, McBride, spotted from behind by Aiden O'Connor, out of bounds. Stay with Roger Bacon.
This game has such a different feel than our first semifinal game in terms of the movement on the court, trying to find different angles offensively to create quick baskets. That's what both these teams are trying to do. Their defensive pressure, which talked about in the opener, and really haven't had an opportunity to get a whole lot of pressure up.
We're already 2-for-2. Makes the front end of a 1-1 here. Roger Bacon. Now perfect from the free throw line today. Now 8-for-8. Second free throw is also good. So Moore gets a both free throw. Easy break of the pressure, and Kimbrough, a running 3 on the left side, is no good. Rebound will come down. Carlos Jackson. Good pass ahead now. The C's parted for McBride, but he missed the layup. Back the other direction, it's Kimbrough, and he's knocked to the floor out there at midcourt. And Kimbrough's got free throws coming up.
We saw the lanes opened up there for Trey McBride. Got himself a little bit off balance, couldn't finish at the basket. Boy, gift right there for the Thunderbirds defensively. Looked like that was going to be an easy score.
So 1-1 for these Kimbrough. Into the bucket, he missed it, but got fouled. 2 free throws coming up now for Tamir Everson.
Everson's one of those players who just kind of hangs around, in the spots he knows he can run through passes. And that time, he got an opportunity to get a quick steal. Got it to the basket. Hard. Got a number now. Committed to not play as a sophomore with a leg injury. He started some games as a freshman for this program. Now he's trying to benefit a strong junior year.
Misfires their first missed free throw of the game as it hits the back of the rim. Simpson back in for Central Catholic. 2:19 left first half, 28-21. Central Catholic leads with Epperson going back to the line here. Connects off the second. Hurts again, a 6-point Central Catholic lead. In the backcourt, Corey Stewart will bounce it over to Simpson, breaks the timeline, pass ahead now to Trey Cobbs. Cobbs back out on top, Simpson at the top of the key. Down to the right-hand corner, Kimbrough. Kimbrough lost the handle, poked out of bounds by Roger Bacon. Stay down 2-0 for Central Catholic.
Remember all these specialty plays underneath. Central Catholic have the ability to score twice on easy baskets. This time, Roger Bacon does a good job. Defense set.
Simpson will control it out on top. Up there by sophomore three. A couple of sophomores going toe-to-toe here. A lot of contact. Pass goes left side, and now on the drive, a foul will be whistled against Carlos Jackson with three throws coming up now again for Kimbrough. And that is for Marvin Jones, who's up to Jackson. Connor back for Simpson. And Ethan O'Connor plays Corey Stewart. I like what Coach Kill has managed to do here today. Rotating players with two fouls in and out of there. Rotating the side with the Reggie Williams. Shade on him. Fouls for Roger Bacon.
This is all about philosophical differences in terms of how you want to play with players who get themselves in foul trouble. It's just tough right now. You got quickness on quickness at both ends of the floor. It's tough to guard people. And the officials are calling it fairly tight right now, so you have to make that adjustment defensively.
1-1 by Kimbrough is good. Green throws the first one in. Second one coming up. Kimbrough now with double figures of 10. Now 11. Here in the first half. Start the day fifth. Now is fourth on the all-time scoring list at Central Catholic. 1:40 left first half. It's an 8-point lead by the T-Birds. Foul against to the deck when Ethan O'Connor, but he's going to get called for the fouls. I think O'Connor was holding up Epperson, and Epperson had enough to kind of shrug him aside.
Well, they both got tangled up there right outside the lane area. And sometimes it's just a matter of the timing effect there. When the official, what he's going to see, he's going to make that call.
It's double bonus time now, so Epperson will shoot two, and the first one is good. Roger Bacon is taking full advantage of getting to the foul line as they have hit 11 out of 12. Dave, they only had 5 field goals in this first half. He had 23 points and only trailed by 7, 56.
Trying to find a way to win the game. If it comes to the free throw line, charity strike, you knock them down on the year. Not a bad shooting free throw team, but they're showing a little bit better on this there.
But an offensive rebound by Wes Higgs lost it, but it was lost out of bounds by Central Catholic. Higgs, a senior, as boy, Coach Neal having to continue to dig deep on that bench on both sides here.
These guys, he's looking down. They're pointing to him. You mean me, Coach? I'm going in.
And the scores table has been like Grand Central Station over there. 1:34 left. 30-23. Roger Bacon down 7 of the ball. Boy, Moore almost lost the inbounds. Great read by Kimbrough to nearly come up with a steal. Lost it out of bounds. Stay with Roger Bacon out in midcourt. What about changing the rule where you can't inbound to the back? I'm just randomly throwing thoughts out there at you. You want to comment on that at all?
No, I'm going to let that one go.
You can't just talk about rule changes in the middle of the state semifinal.
No, I'm a traditionalist. Old school, let's play the way the rules are set.
Okay. They have evolved over time, by the way.
Few things have changed in the high school game. Besides the three-point shot, of course, a lot of different things in terms of how the National Federation and then, of course, the High School Association have built it down to them. You don't have to make changes to the national trade. You see a lot of different things. I think the shot clock is one thing that a lot of people, that just discussion seems to be taking a little bit stronger traction here as of late.
Two free throws for Trey McBride. And he misfires on the first one. It's still 30-23. So the Catholic on top, 1:15 to play. McBride will step up for the second one here. He nailed a pair earlier. He got 4 points in the game off the bench. Free throw is up and it's good. 6-point game now. The pressure here by Roger Bacon hasn't really given Central Catholic much problem. As Simpson will dribble it into the front court, dumps it down low, getting right to the basket, but overshooting was Jake Williams. And we've got a foul on the shot. Williams going to go to the line. Some may have thought it was a late whistle, but William Green's going to get called for the foul.
And Jake Williams, 6'3" junior, finding a way to put himself totally engaged offensively. Doesn't come off penetration or receiving passes from a spectacular backcourt. It's being on the offensive glass and getting himself in free throw line and free throw.
Free throw is up and good by Williams. Now has 5 points on the day. 1:02 left, second quarter. 31-24 winner will take on Villa Angela St. Joe. The D3 title game tomorrow at 4:30. Williams shoots these at 65%. Gets the back rim with the second one. Fight for the rebound. Saved well by Carlos Jackson. And Roger Bacon with the possession. Pretzels will charge his way down the floor. Had his pocket picked, but a foul will be called. And that's going to go on Aiden O'Connor. It's a result of free throws now on the other end here. Austin Prinsum.
Thunderbirds coach Frank Gill. Active on the sideline, emotional. Involved in this basketball game. Both these coaches. I got to be right now.
Coach Gill won a state championship in 1997 playing for Lincoln. Member as assistant back in 2010. Central Catholic won the state title. And he's looking very knelt down over there, but you can see the wheels are turning about 1,000 miles an hour right now.
There's no officials made any calls in the last 3.5 seconds. But frankly, and I gotta love it because he's active. Any call is going against him in the right way. He's just very engaged in the basketball game.
Renzo splits the pairs. He had missed the first, gets the second, checks out of the lineup. He does have 2 fouls as well. 53 seconds to play, and it's still a 6-point game. 31-25, Simpson up to 4. Get over here on the left side for Cobbs. Back out to Simpson in front. Back to Cobbs down the corner. Skips it back out on top to Kimberly. Now it's Simpson over here in front of us. Lobs it back cross court to Kimberly. Gets this defense of Emerson at 6'3 out there. How can these two guards, as they just lob it, play keep away back and forth? Game clock under 30. Out of the corner, bad decision there as Cobbs quickly double teams. He's got it back out to Kimbrough, now Simpson.
As you know what's happening when the ball goes towards the baseline, Roger Bacon's going to trap that very, very hard. Long and lengthy. Very difficult to get that ball reversed back out.
All right, last 10. Simpson's got it in the left front court. 9 seconds. Simpson down the sideline, 7. Lots it back over to Kimbrough on the right point. 3 ball on the way. Hits the rim and glass. Rebound and a foul with 1.6 seconds to go. And it's right against Roger Bacon. Coming up for Lima Central Catholic. And it's the second call on Fred Ward.
Old school is when you try to run the clock down at the end of the quarter, enter the half to get your last shot. The best thing you can do as an offensive player along the baseline is crash the boards. And that's exactly what the Thunderbirds did.
First free throw by Ethan O'Connor is good. O'Connor now with 3 off the bench. Started 4 of their 27 games coming into today. Sophomore's second one, a little strong. Rebound grab by Roger Bacon, given to Reggie Williams, whose long shot will be after the horn. So we have reached halftime. Our score, it is Lima Central Catholic 32 and Roger Bacon 25. When we come back, we will talk with the head coach of Villa Angela St. Joe's, Coach Kwasniak, right after this message from our local station. You're listening to the OHSAA Radio Network.
You know, hockey's it's a sport that you don't have to be a hardcore hockey fan to watch. I'm always hearing that when people come to Nationwide, they have a blast. There's the cannon that goes off, there's giveaways, there's t-shirts flying around the building out of the Gatling gun. As a fan, you have a chance to be a part of something now. I can tell you this, if you come to a game, you're going to be in for a heck of a ride. And it's going to be fun for a long time. Join us. Be a part of it.
Get to go now at BlueJackets.com.
Arcade Fire Return Reflector Tour. The critically acclaimed new album Reflector. Available now. April 29th at Schottenstein Center. Tickets are on sale now. Buy tickets at Ticketmaster. The box office will charge by phone.
Hi, I'm former Major League Baseball All-Star Al Ola. When I play, I try to make it a simple game. I just hit the ball and move on. But trust me, it's important, but not that simple. Try to remember that when you try to get a scratch with athletic contests, everyone is trying their best. The game they all love. So please, be sure to set an example that will bring positive work to the school and community. Just remember, too, respect the game.
Ohio High School Athletic Association licenses over 16,000 officials in 16 different sports.
OHSAA officials are parents, teachers, police officers, firefighters, homemakers, engineers, and bus drivers.
Officiating gives us a chance to give back and support kids across the state of Ohio.
It's a tough job, but we love what we do.
Both point guards for both teams don't score a whole lot, but for both teams, they're both the leaders. And his strategy was a good one. He was gonna try not to let Carlton and Brian beat him, and he kind of played off Mo and Vaughn Johnson, our little point guard number 10. And I thought Mo made some big plays, and he had some he had some great numbers. I think he had 11 points, 8 rebounds, and 4 assists. And ironically enough, Duke just lost to Mercer. Our point guard last year, Dwayne Gibson, who Mo played behind, had 26, 8, and 7 versus Mercer. So it's a pretty good day for St. Joe point guards.
Hey, I was very impressed with one of your juniors. And you think about Brian Parker and what he's done to this basketball program. And I know he's only a junior pro player of the year, but I thought in the second half he was the difference maker. He was totally engaged in the basketball game. Talk about his performance.
Yeah, Dave, his father, Brian Parker, was a great player, played for Kevin Mackey at Cleveland State, and Brian's just a beast. You know, he's a throwback where you got all these, you got the AAU now, and you got all these kids that want to play with each other. Brian just wants to, if you have the other uniform on, Brian wants to hurt you. And, from a competitive spirit standpoint, from a coach, it's kind of refreshing. You know, he's not trying to be your friend. He's not trying to kiss you. He's trying to bury you, and he's just so competitive. And, being on a state championship team last year really helped him. He learned from some really good role models. He's a four-point student. He's got a lot of the Ivy Leagues on him.
What's the challenge when you have as athletic and you commit to a very talented basketball team? Is there a challenge trying to make sure they all kind of blend together and that they share the ball, which I think is the common denominator of all these teams in the state championship? But your team especially looks like a very unselfish.
Well, I tell people all the time, we're very talented, but we make up for it by being very, very poorly coached. So, yeah, you know what? We can only control what we control, Dave. And And our kids, you know, what we hang our hat on is we're playing for something bigger than ourselves. You know, I mean, we're going for history, not only to be the first team to win in all divisions, but, you know, to have six state championships and we can get it done tomorrow. You know, when you talk about our place, you talk about Clark Kellogg, Elvis Gerbach, Desmond Howard, David Lighty. I better name some more Ohio State people and not Michigan people. But, you know, our place has obviously been special. It's been special for a long time. And you're right, it is a challenge, but our kids know that when they come to our place. They know when they come to our place that they're probably not going to win Mr. Basketball. They're probably not going to win a lot of individual awards. But the reward is that they get to play in games like this, and this beats all of that.
We talked before the game, Coach, about what would the tempo be? Would it end up being more Reedy style, the slower pace? Would it be a higher pace? And you've won games at all different point totals this year. I'm not sure if you're aware. That was your tie for your lowest point total of the season at 55 points today. Yet you've won both of those games when you scored 55 points. You can be a very versatile basketball team.
And our schedules helped us for that. We played five teams that are 1 point ranked in the top 10 in the country. We played four teams that are here this weekend. St. Ed's guards you about as good as anybody. You guys will see them tonight. And I thought they were very similar in the way they tried to guard us. Obviously, offensively, Ed's a lot better. You know, give those kids credit because really they hit some shots in the first half. And you're absolutely right. We've seen all styles this year. Very eclectic mix, and that helped us.
I know your wheels are turning. You've had a chance to see a first half of this basketball, the other semifinal game. Give your impressions of either of these teams, Lima Central Catholic, Roger Bacon.
Great guards, very well coached. I had a chance to meet Frank at the coach's clinic for Lima this summer. Roger Bacon obviously has a storied history. You know, you don't get here by accident, Dave. It's going to be, there's a lot of talent out here, and it's that time of year where, you're going to play somebody, and you're going to play somebody pretty good.
Congratulations on the win, 55-40 today over Reedy. See you tomorrow at 4:30.
Thank
right
you,
here.
Gentlemen.
Head coach Babe Wozniak from Villa Angela St. Joe. They will take on the winner of our second game, which is at halftime. And right now it's Central Catholic leading Roger Bacon 32-25. Dave and I are back at Value City Arena after this timeout. For your local sponsors, you're listening to the OHSAA Radio Network.
I'm Professor Burke from Farmers Insurance, and this is 30 Seconds of Smart. So you want discounts on your home insurance. Upgrade your roof. Upgrade your plumbing. Get a burglar alarm. Get a fire alarm. Combine policies with your spouse. And, of course, talk to Farmers, because the more you know about home insurance, the more you can save.
We are Farmers. Bum, ba, bum,
bum, bum, bum. Get smarter about your insurance at Farmers.com. To speak with a Farmers agent in your community, call 888-96-FARMERS.
Welcome to the home of Gridiron Legends, the newly renovated Pro Football Hall of Fame in Canton, Ohio. Walk among the immortals of football inside the Hall of Fame gallery. Here you can stand face-to-face with the men who built America's game. Relive the greatest moments of Super Bowl history in the Lamar Hunt Super Bowl Gallery and stand before the Vince Lombardi Trophy, while the NFL Today Gallery is home to the NFL's most recent record-breaking moments. Plan your visit to the Pro Football Hall of Fame today at ProFootballHOF.com.
We have learned that one five teens have used prescription medications not prescribed for them that can lead to serious addictions. This is Governor John Kasich. Drugs are destroying our communities and taking futures away from our young people. That is why safety partners like the Ohio State Highway Patrol and the Ohio National Guard have joined forces to give our young folks 5 minutes of life, a program dedicated to reducing drug use among Ohio teens. Learn more about the program at facebook.com/5minutes for life.
Help create the association's program on sporting behavior. Through the Respect the Game campaign, we are encouraging student athletes, parents, fans, coaches, and officials to do three important things. Speak with courtesy, act with dignity, and play or observe with pride.
Lions WDBN AM 1310, Kelly Copy WDBN AM 1350 AM, Midland WDBN AM 1330.
talk about the highlight things yet. I want to talk about just kind of the play itself in terms of it's been kind of the way this game has been officiated. Not a very, I guess, pretty game in terms of the flow of the game. So I think both teams have been, I think it's impressive, but I'm going to have a little deeper as well. The thing that stands out for my highlighter is 29.4% shooting percentage for Roger Bacon. One year to shoot close to 46%. A big difference. They need, just like you talked about, teams coming from this building, you need to make some shots. If you make some shots, it makes everything look a little bit better on the stat sheet.
Bob Brady in the first game, they shot under 30% in the game, and 20% in the second half. They bow out. We're underway in our third quarter. Roger Bacon with basketball staring right at the 1-3-1 defense. Reggie Williams will go right for Roger Bacon, gives Emerson to instead of a foul. Back out to Reggie Williams, coming left with Carlos Jackson. Jackson back out on top down to Williams. Williams will move right to the basketball, hands to Emerson. Top, on down low, deflected, and it'll be stolen here. Turnover number 10 today for Roger Bacon. On the left side, it'll be Kimbrough down to the corner for Simpson. Makes left with right hands to Kimbrough. Step back three on the way, rolls off the rim. Rebound, Fred Moore for Roger Bacon. 45 seconds here of our third quarter, and Roger Bacon still trails by seven. We'll change here defensively in the second half for the T-Birds.
And I think the Spartans are not surprised by the 1-3-1 they saw the last possession. They still got to handle that and be able to execute a good push out right here to the basket.
And with the air ball by Carlos Jackson on one end, the Kimbrough back the other way will get a bucket and a foul will be called on Roger Bacon. And Neeson a little shaken up after the collision underneath.
Martins Kimbrough picked up that ball underneath the basket at the far end. About five or six dribbles to the basket, a little off balance. Lima got it to go, an opportunity here for that 3-point play.
And Austin Frenzos plays Carlos Jackson in the lineup. Has a 3-point play opportunity here for Kimbrough. So the first points of the second half for Central Catholic, and the lead back out tonight could be 10, which would be the largest. After Kimbrough tucks in the shirt. Step up to the line. Kimbrough now 13 points on the day. Free throw is good. 14 points for one of the co-players of the year this year in Division III. 10-point advantage. Spartans have got to find it offensively. Frenzos on the left side with the basketball. Still 1-3-1 for Central Campbell. Williams back over to Frenzos. Now back over on the right side. And now on top is Antez Walton, a 6-4. Makes it doubly hard. Got a kick. Out on top of that 1-3-1. You get an active person on top. It's a tough task.
Long and athletic. Really makes those passes. But that's not the pass you have to concentrate on. Almost like an accordion effect. You got to get the ball moving and then drive the gaps of that 1-3-1. That will free up some baseline look. But another turnover going the other way for the Thunderbird.
Great save by Kimbrough back in bounds. And then Cobbs will be held by Emerson out on the drive. And the body language right now for Roger Bacon, Dave, not very good. 6:25 to play in the third. They're down by 10.
That's the offensive reps, and I think he's coming back on the floor right now. Carlos Jackson, to me, is the best player for the Spartans. He's got to get himself totally engaged offensively. He's well below. He's not shooting well. He's had three turnovers. He has not played well. And I think he, in order for him and this basketball team to have an opportunity to get back in the game, he's really got to step it up.
Connect
on that pass.
Ray McBride
that's the way they're going to call it. You have to make the adjustments, or else you are going to put yourself way behind here, and then late in the game, you could become that reversal contest.
Dobbs inside, and a foul. That's going to be on Carlos Jackson. And this will result in free throws now. And that is number four on Carlos Jackson.
Just the last three or four possessions offensively started to get in some kind of a rhythm. Now you have to take a seat over on the bench, watch from the sideline when your team really desperately needs you.
And in less than 5 game minutes of the third quarter, Lima Central Catholic now in the bonus. And a 9-point lead.
Jake Wood, standing first half, trying to contribute here in the third.
And the front end of the 1-1 is good. Now give Jake Williams 6 points, along with 6 rebounds on the day. Junior steps up, had 8 points in their regional final. Bounce off of him and rebounded by Trey McBride for Roger Baker, who trails by 10. Frentzos on the far side. Out to McBride. Over here to Neeson. And the 1-3-1. They'll trap out of it on top. Pass will come to Epperson. Cross court to Frentzos now. Frentzos lobs it over top. Neeson tries a three. Top of the key. Hit the front of the rim. Long rebound grab by Cobbs. Cobbs will take it in right against Neeson. Bounces it over to Williams. Frentzos blocked the shot out of bounds.
Good effort. In transition defense. Get back the floor. Trying to help your basketball team any which way right now.
Reggie Williams, well, had gotten to the table but didn't get into the lineup. Inbounds will go, and now a foul line jump shot no good by Kimbrough. Epperson, the rebound for Roger Bacon. Pushes it into the front court now. Bounces it off to Trey McBride. McBride left with the key, hands to Frentzos. 2.5 left in the third. Neeson up along the sideline, back with the Frentzos. Crosses over, top of the key, dumps it right side, Epperson. He'll drive, floats it up off the glass with the left hand. No good. Rebound, Jake Williams from Central Catholic. Now Trey Cobbs in the back row, been picked up by Epperson. Central Catholic with the ball and a 10-point lead here in the third. On top it is Kimbrough. Makes right, goes left, passes into the wing now to Ethan O'Connor. Back out on top, and the ball knocked out of Walton's hands. Frentzos diving down, and a tie up here. No, a timeout will be used by Central Catholic, and a technical foul has been assessed to, I believe, Demir Epperson for Roger Bacon. And it is. So Epperson will get the technical, which will also be a personal foul, which will be assessed. And I have that being his third. And so we'll let them all sort it out. The timeout will occur first. And it comes with 1:56 to play here in the third quarter. And Central Catholic leads 39-29. Today's game brought to you by Chocolate Milk. Fuel up with Chocolate Milk. Farmers Insurance. We are insurance. We are farmers. Sports Time Ohio. Fans for life. By Burger King. Taste is king. Marathon. Fueling the American spirit. And by Time Warner Cable. Enjoy high school sports better.
Well, they sort this out. Two things stand out in my mind thus far in this basketball game. And it started at the start of the second half. But Lima Central Catholic went to that 1-3-1 zone defense in the half court. Roger Bacon has been out of sorts, no rhythm offensively. Last possession, they got a little penetration. They're playing now without Carlos Jackson, who has 4 fouls. And that little emotional outburst there from Epperson gives, again, Catholic Central that momentum. Right now, momentum is one thing you want to try to get on your side. And it seems like the Thunderbirds here, Todd, have had it most of the second half.
I noticed at one point, it was several possessions ago, Roger Bacon had scored, Dave, and Coach Neal doing the